All right, we're on the worldwide internet and Facebook, and let's all just give the Lord Jesus a great big hand clap. They know we love him too far. This is the day the Lord has paid. We ought to rejoice and be glad in it. Amen.
Amen.
I'm gonna sing a couple of good songs for us. Please get your pencil and paper and be ready at the end of the service to write down our address and if you want a prayer call and all these good things, we'll send it right to you. So Brother Don, come on and sing us a couple of good songs.
Amen. Good evening, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Good evening, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise God.
Go ahead.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And I said, oh, Lord, I see the book of my son.
Yes,
I
thank God that he reached way down for me and he picked me up. I was in the Church of Christ, my dad and mother was. But I never could see it like that. And I began to pray, and I wasn't a Christian, but God reached down and he dealt with me about the
Yes, amen.
We need the Holy Ghost move on my tie, tie in our life today.
Yes, Lord.
If we don't have it in these last days, it's going to be hard for us to stand.
Yes.
And I thank him for every blessing. I thank him for Amen. All of you.
Yes.
I appreciate every one of you and love
Praise
you.
God. Praise,
Praise God.
God. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Thank you. You know, there, I was one. Didn't think I was worthy of the Lord. That's this song just touches my heart. And I know that there are so many other people out there that just don't feel worthy enough. I've talked to people and they said, oh no, I've done too much bad in my life. I'm not worthy to be one of a person that follows Lord. But you know something? All you have to do is just give your heart over to the Lord.
Amen.
And ask him in your heart. Study his word. Read his word.
Yes,
and you'll
amen.
Find your word each and every day. Thank you.
Thank you.
you're going to get happy. Then Simon Peter said, rejoice. In case you didn't hear him, he said, rejoice.
Yes.
Again.
Amen.
God inhabits the praises of his people.
Yes, he does. Amen.
I mean, he gets excited. Pats his big foot on the throne.
Yes.
I believe that sometimes causes an earthquake in the church. And I love to preach on joy because it's God that inhabits the joy of his saints. When you read in the Bible of a king rejoicing, you'd think he had a lot of pride, probably he did. But that's what won a battle. King Jehoshaphat. The odds were probably 10-1 against him. One of the men, runners, came to him and said, we're surrounded. What are we going to do? How are we going to do it? Jehoshaphat said, I just don't know. But he thought just for a minute, and he thought, well, now, let's call fast. Don't you think that would be good for the churches today to call fast?
Amen.
I know people absolutely, their bellies is their God. They don't want to hear nothing about fasting. Amen. But that's what he did. He called a fast. He called Judah and Jerusalem together. And it's time to have a prayer meeting, friends, when you're surrounded by the devil and the enemy.
Come on.
Amen.
It's time to pray. It's time to seek God.
Amen.
Because joy and gladness has ceased, it seems to me, like in the house of God. You have seldom see people coming through the door spontaneously like we used to and lifting up holy hands without wrath and doubting and praising the Lord. But God inhabits your praises.
Yes, he does.
You are important to him.
Yes.
Not only end up like the strong man Samson that became a clown. And the devil laughed at him because he lost his joy and he lost his power.
Amen.
Had his eyes plucked out, burned out.
Amen.
In a prison house, grinding corn.
Yes.
And, of course, he prayed one more time. Asked God to restore his strength and his hair began to grow again.
Praise God.
Killed more men at his death than he did in all of his lifetime.
Amen.
Now, when you talk about joy, as I mentioned, King Jehoshaphat was a great king. The Bible says he was a great king. But he was a king that didn't have so much pride and sophisticated that you couldn't figure him out because he knew what it was to have joy. That's why he got some singers in the church and got them together. Put them up in the first rank. You've heard me preach this so many times. But I just feel like preaching joy tonight. Is it all right if I preach a little bit of joy?
Amen.
And he put those singers. Now the Bible says when he had called Judah and Jerusalem together for a prayer meeting, there's no doubt they began to pray.
Yes.
And the Spirit of the Lord came in the midst of the church and said, hearken, King Jehoshaphat. Hearken, Jerusalem. Hearken, Judah. The battle is not your battle. The battle is the Lord's battle.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And he said, here's what I want you to do. I want you to put some singers up front. I think sometimes he might have said, I want you to put some big mouth singers up front.
Yes.
Put them in the front ranks and let them go into the enemy's camp.
Yep.
Yes. Amen.
I can almost visualize.
Yes.
All of them going over a mountain, and it sounded like a million of them coming. Guess what they had for weapons? They had a song in their mouth.
That's right.
Yes.
And the song was this.
Praise
ye the Lord, for his mercy endures forever. Praise ye the Lord, for his mercy endures forever. It probably sounded like millions of them coming.
Yes.
Amen.
They had no sword, no spear, no weapon.
No.
All they had was praise in their mouth.
Come on.
Amen.
Praise and the praise won the battle.
Amen.
As they marched into the enemy's camp, they got past the watchtower. The enemy had fled and drew swords on one another and killed one another.
That's right.
And God's little army with nothing but a song in their mouth.
Amen.
And can I tell you that when they dedicated Solomon's temple, they sang that song also. And as they were singing that song, praise you the Lord, the Bible says a Shekinah glory came in the midst of them.
Amen.
And the priest couldn't minister by reason of that glory.
Praise God.
I can imagine the trumpeters and the singers became as one. And they began to rejoice.
Yes.
And magnify God and praise
yeah.
God. They didn't have no shame about praising the Lord. We got a lot of people praying shame to lift their
hands. That's
hand.
Right.
A lot of people ashamed to praise their hand. I sing that song sometimes. Pharaoh got my people bound. They can't clap their hand. Pharaoh got my people bound. They can't sing no more. Pharaoh got my people bound. They don't want a joy. They don't want no joy.
Amen.
But the prophet Nehemiah said, the joy of the Lord is your strength. Joy unspeakable and full of glory. Is the church's weapon tonight against the satanic demonic forces that we are confronted with in this hour. And if we don't get some joy and gladness in the churches, we're gonna wither away. I tell you tonight, it's time that the church lifts up our standard against the devil and say, for me and my house, we are gonna praise the Lord in the midst of this crooked and perverse generation. No matter what happens, this is God's hour of praise and magnifying his name as Jehoshaphat did in the days of old. You know what they did? They went into the enemy's camp and everybody dead. Threw swords on one another in confusion. God knows how to cause confusion too. Down they went. I can almost see sometimes they walking over and there's one dead. He said, hey, Bill, that guy's dead. Yeah, he's dead. I get his money. Now, the Bible says it's taken 3 days to strip them of their wealth that they had. And the Bible says also that their jewelry, their nose rings, earrings, they've taken everything that they had. God's little army went out there pretty wealthy. 3 days! You think about it, 3 days to get their wealth. Now they must have had a whole lot of wealth. They must have had a whole lot to shout about, amen?
Amen.
Praise God. And here comes the little army with nothing but praise in their mouth.
Amen.
Praise ye the Lord. Everybody help me. Praise ye the Lord for his joy. His joy is forever. 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 Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to get gladness back in the house. We're going to get joy in the house. If we ever overcome and have the overcoming spirit that God wants us to have, we've got to have the joy of the Lord, which is your strength tonight, that you can fight with this weapon that God's given you. Thou put down stronghold, cast down imagination, and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God.
Amen, that's right.
I've been up here thinking just a few minutes ago, will the people accept a message like this tonight?
Amen.
Will you accept the joy that God wants you to have? Oh, somebody said it's hard to shout in this day and time. This is a time we ought to be shouting and magnifying God. And lifting up holy hands without laughing and doubting.
Amen.
And let the world know we're not ashamed to praise God. I'm not ashamed to praise
Him.
He's done so much for me. He brought me out of a lot of things in this world. And I'm going to tell you tonight, I'm excited because I know He's coming soon.
Amen.
I know the day of the Lord is at hand. And that's why we need to lift up a standard and say, bless God, you're not going to steal my joy. You're not going to take my peace of mind that God has given me. A lot of people don't even have the peace of mind anymore.
Yes.
I want the peace of mind that the Bible says God has not given us the spirit of fear, but the spirit of power and of love and of a sound mind.
Yes.
A lot of folks' minds are troubled. What's going to happen tomorrow? Looks like we all going down the tube.
Amen.
Looks like the devil's going to win. I heard one preacher say, guess who's winning?
Amen.
He said, the devil's winning. The devil's getting more souls than God is getting.
Yes.
Well, I'm going to tell you something. There's come the time that that little imp,
yes,
the Bible tells us we're going to look upon him.
Hallelujah.
And we're going to say, is this the one that weakened the nations?
Yes.
Yeah, we're going to see him.
Amen.
We got the weapons to fight with.
Yes.
And the 10-year-old mouse.
Amen.
When you get down and discouraged,
yes,
and it seems like everything's going wrong, that's yes, the time to lift holy hands and pray to God. And run through the house. Amen. When you dust the women, when you dust the washing dishes, begin to sing a song and praise God. Watch that holy presence spirit on you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Praise
do
the
a little dancing if you want to. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Did we get a happy enough in the house? Let's do a little dancing.
Yes.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
God, ain't nothing wrong with it. The Bible's full.
Amen.
When they crossed the Red Sea, the women.
Yes.
Everybody say women.
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 After they got on the other side, they all got a tambourine. Now you're talking about the dust flying. They got in a dance and they danced so much the dust flew up in the air. No doubt about it.
Praise God.
Saying, praise ye the Lord.
Amen.
Because God has brought them to the Red Sea.
Amen.
And yet they doubted God.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
How can you doubt God when he brought a miracle like that?
Amen.
Amen.
When the Red Sea just dried up, just parted.
Amen.
Like Jell-O, just fell back. They tell us that's what they made the movie out of, Jell-O, or the parting of the Red Sea.
Praise
I don't know
God.
If that's true or not, but that's Hollywood made it like that.
Yes.
But it happened anyway.
Yes.
Pharaoh's army behind them, the mountains on either side, and the sea before them.
Mm-hmm.
And Moses stressed out, they said, when he put out his rod, probably people said, well, you mean we want to go over on that little rod? They thought that's what was always going to have to get the Red Sea apart. No.
Holy Lord.
I believe they began to praise God.
Amen.
I believe amen. Moses lifted up that rod and prayed and spoke that water and it just parted, hit it and so. My God, when Elijah came down to Jordan,
yes,
he had followed Elijah all the way. I don't believe he closed his eyes. He followed the man. He had something that he wanted. And it wasn't religion, church.
Amen.
It was salvation of the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen.
And he followed Elijah all the way down to Bethel. Didn't stop there. Went on down. The sons of God were standing on the outside looking in. And they got down to Jordan. And the sons of God were up on the mountaintop watching all this take place. They knew that Elijah was going to be raptured out that day, but they didn't want none of that power. Don't seem to me like they wanted any of it. But when Elijah taken that mantle and struck the water and hit parted, and they went over on dry shore. Now I like this part. As they was going over, he said, ask of me, before I'm taken out of it. He knew he was going up.
Amen.
And he said, I want a double portion of thy spirit.
Amen.
Well, he said, you've asked a hard thing. That meant some of us, we'd have to leave your pocketbook behind. You know, we need to find the card back here. We need some money. But he asked for a double portion of the spirit of God.
Amen.
He said, if you see me when I go up, nevertheless, you can have it.
Praise God.
Brother, when he went up, here come a chariot of fire, the horses of fire. And Elijah got on board, and there he went. And he's in heaven tonight, alive.
Amen.
He's going to be one of the witnesses that come back in Jerusalem in the tribulation period.
Amen.
Amen.
And when he went up, that mantle fell back. He went over and picked it up. He went over to that sea.
Yes, hallelujah.
And he spoke to water, just like Elijah did. And he said, where is the Lord God of Elijah? Now I got a question to ask tonight. Where is the Elijahs of God at tonight?
Amen.
Where are they at? Where is the power of the Holy Ghost that used to work in our churches?
Amen.
Where is the gift of the Spirit of God?
Come on.
Where are they at? Because gladness and joy has dried up in the sons of God. There was a time that blue seemed like women, blue blazers. I'm not preaching on nobody's looks or hair or anything like that, but there was a time, they tell us, at the beginning of the outpouring of the Spirit of God, that women's hair would, they would sling it, and it, and it sounded like a whip.
Yes.
Praise God.
Oh, my praise God. I ain't gonna say no more about that.
Praise the Lord.
Joy unspeakable and full of glory.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
He'll help you through many trials.
Yes.
Amen.
And pestilence and storm. Don't never give up.
Amen.
Never, never give up.
Amen.
Fight that good fight of faith to the last
day. Amen.
You got God on your side tonight.
Amen.
You got the majority on your side.
Amen.
You got the Son, you got the Father, you got the Son, you got the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
All three of them on
Amen.
Your side tonight. You got all the angels, tens
Amen.
Of thousands, tens of thousands, and tens of thousands.
Amen.
And they are ministering spirits to those who are heirs of salvation.
Amen.
They minister for you.
Praise
Brother,
God.
I'm going to tell you, I said this many times, one big angel slew 185 men. Woo!
Praise God.
One big angel. He must have had some joy.
Praise the Lord.
The joy of the Lord, as Simon Peter said, is your strength.
Amen.
The joy. Joy, joy, unspeakable.
Praise
joy.
God.
Just like Nehemiah, the king, that went against the odds and against the people.
Amen.
And won the battle with nothing but joy in their mouth.
Amen. Praise
God. I'll tell you, friend.
Thank you, Lord.
If we don't get joy back in our churches,
Amen.
For people, you know, sometimes I look over the congregation, I see people squirming, wanting to get out of here. We got to get up at McDonald's here. You know.
Oh, no.
Amen.
Amen.
I said, amen.
Amen.
Get mad at me if you want to. I don't care.
Praise God.
I made up my mind. I'm going to quit worrying about what people think about
amen.
Me preaching.
Amen. Amen.
That's right.
I've been doing this too long to quit now.
Amen.
I've been in this thing for a long time.
That's right.
And I've went through a whole lot of tests and trials and storms of life. But I'm still holding fast to my confession of faith without wavering, because I count him faithful who promised.
Amen.
He promised to never leave me or
Amen.
No faith forsake me,
God.
But go with me all the way. And when all hell comes at you, you still got the winning team on your side. And he'll never fail you.
Amen.
He'll never let you down.
That's right.
There's been times that looked like that we've gone under. It's time that we went through hard times.
Yes.
He said, if we suffer with him, we drain with him.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, it's not always a flower bed that eases up. There's times that we went through some hard times.
Yes.
But we fought that good fight of faith.
Yes.
Amen. One sister told me one time, said, Brother Burgess, if anybody's got a right to backslide, said, you have. Yeah. I thought, God gave his son. Abraham offered his son.
Amen.
I have to give my son. I'm still not going to backslide.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
There have been many men and women have backslid because of losing a child.
Yes.
I don't think there's anything in this world worse than losing a child.
Amen.
Amen.
And death. When I thought about all these 100,000 little children and a lamb, that they put a chain around their neck of gold or something like that, sent them out into a minefield. Every one of them was blown up, and the parents okayed it. That just happened not very long ago. And when we talk about tribulations, it's tribulations for them people over there. When they're cutting
Amen.
People's heads off, that's tribulation.
Amen.
Now, I know in the sixth chapter of Revelations, I know that the the Antichrist on the white horse, and the red horse, and the black horse, and the pale horse, and the green horse, which I believe is kind of looking green to me. I don't know, some people call it that. Islam is just about ready to start riding. It just seems like tomorrow something's going to happen.
Yes.
I got expectations that something is going to happen.
Amen.
Either a war with Israel or a rapture of the church out of here. Not one scripture has to be fulfilled.
Amen.
And we got pre-trib, mid-trib, and post-trib, and we are pre-trib, we believe, in the first load out of here. You can stay around and go through the tribulation if you want to.
Amen.
But we are chosen of God.
Yes.
You can't come back from somewhere you've been. And I find in the Bible when the tribulation period is over, that then there will be appearance of the Son of God in the sky.
Amen.
Yes, hallelujah.
Oh, what time.
Amen.
When it seems like that the whole world is going to go be defeated by the Antichrist. Well, I don't want to get on him tonight. I'm talking about joy.
Amen.
You can't have joy and talk about the Antichrist. Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
But the peace of God that passes understanding will keep our hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. You can have peace of mind in troublesome times, in dangerous times that we're living in. In the days of darkness in which we're going through right now.
Amen.
When it seems like the world has gone mad, believe me, it seems like everything is going wrong and is happening so fast. Even in the word of knowledge, it talked about, Daniel talked about there'll be an explosion of knowledge. And we've had explosions of knowledge that
you invent
something today, tomorrow it's obsolete. Something else done taking its place. These are the trying times when the church needs joy.
Yes.
They don't need fear. Fear will hold you in bondage. Fear will make you sick.
Amen.
I said fear will make you sick. It will.
Yes.
Amen.
That's why God gives you the peace of mind that passes all understanding.
Yes. Amen.
Claim it. Take it. Because it belongs to you.
Amen.
The devil will scare you to death if he can.
Yeah. Yeah.
I said, he'll scare you to death if he can.
Yeah.
You're not going to make it. You're going under.
That's right.
You're going to die.
Don't believe it.
That's the way he talks. He don't talk. He don't tell you how good you are. He don't tell you that you're going to be an overcomer. He don't tell you things like that. But he's out to stop the church. And the only weapon he has is a deceitful and deceiving way to do it. He makes you think things that's not real.
Yeah.
You know that?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. God told me to tell you get up and say something. Come on. I don't know what you're going to say, but...
God is good. God's an awesome God. You know, God is still on the throne. I'm so thankful to be alive today in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
I'm talking to all you people out there in the internet land tonight.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you right now... God is real. He's still on the cross. I'll tell you right now, he's looking out on the seashores and looking out across this nation, Brother Aiden, and he's looking for those that are willing to come and give their heart to him and accept him as their personal Savior tonight.
Amen.
And all you have to do, all you need to do, is pray and ask God to forgive you of your sins.
Right.
Confess your sins before him, acknowledge and tell him that you know that he is the Son of the living God, and he will save your lost soul. He will come and take up his abode inside you. He will lead you by his sweet Holy Spirit. I'm thankful that we have a God that cares so much about us. I'm thankful so much tonight that no matter where we're at, no matter what happened, no matter what it looks like out there in this world, God is still on the throne. God is still moving by his sweet Holy Spirit. He is still directing our lives. He is still directing the church. He is in charge and control of the church. No matter what the enemy might tell you, God is still in control of the church. The enemy like Brother Burgess said, has nothing but deceiving power, but God has all power on heaven and on earth. And I'm standing here tonight, I'm looking at you people out there in the internet tonight, and I'm telling you, God is still on the throne. He is still in charge. He is still in control. And all you need to do is accept him as your personal savior, and he'll lead you. And when you seem like there's nowhere to go, when it seems like there's no way, he will make a way for you. He said, I will never leave you. He said, I will never forsake you. He said, I will go with you to the very end. And when you go to the very end, hey, he's talking about the very end of this walk. Yes, when you have walked this journey, when you have gone to the very end, and he calls you over now, Jordan, and he calls you home, he's standing there on that shore of the Jordan River, and he's standing there, and he's waiting for you. He's waiting there with his open arms to receive you into his arms, receive you into glory land. I thank God that he is alive and he's still doing what he said he would do.
Amen.
I know that he's in charge, Brother Burgess, because I feel it in my heart, and I feel him down inside of me, and I know that he's in control because he watches over all of his people. And when the enemy tries to deceive you, he is there to lead you if you will just listen to what he has to say. Don't go out there and attend and say, I don't have to listen to God. But I'm telling you, you better start listening to God, because we're out of time when the end is coming.
Amen.
And the enemy is all at hand. Yes. He is out there deceiving those that he can. And it's starting out over in the Middle East, and it's moving across the nation over into the United States, because the United States has turned their back on God.
Amen.
And it's time that people get a hold of this. They better get a hold of the horns of the altar, and they better pray, because the time is short, Brother Aiden. The time is drawing close, and it's time for us, the people of the church, the Christians, to get a hold of the altar, get on fire for God, and do what he has called and told us to do. That's what it's all about. It's not about you and I. It's about him. It's about going, making it in. It's about making it over onto that other side. And I thank God, because he is still in control of my life. And I know that he's in control, because he always keeps me. He protects me. I do some stupid things and I get hurt, but God is still on the throne. And I'm still thanking God that he is still there. He is still leading me. He is still watching and protecting me. I fell recently about a month ago and I got injured. But God has raised me up.
Amen.
And I'm thanking him in advance. And I know that I'm going to be victorious, and all the pain will be gone. For over a month, I was wearing a support on my back. And I've taken that support off for the last 2-3 days, and I'm not wearing it, because God has touched my back. And when you slam in the edge of a platform in a church with your back, it hurts. I will not say it doesn't. I know it hurts, because it's so bad. Brother Don had to take me home.
That's right.
But I went home and I placed ice on my back, and I laid there for a couple of hours, and I come back that night because I wanted to be in the presence of the Almighty God. I wanted to be in fellowship with him. I wanted to be in fellowship with his people. I wanted to know.
Amen.
I want people to know that God is still in control.
Amen.
All right.
Yeah. He's an awesome God tonight.
Yes, he is.
He's an awesome God, and I love him, and I thank him that I have this privilege and honor to stand here tonight and to speak the words that God has given unto me.
Praise
I'm going to turn it back over to Brother Burgess.
Praise the Lord.
I call him out of season, I guess, but he ought to be ready. Hallelujah. Every preacher ought to be ready to stand when God tells them to stand.
Amen.
Study to show ourselves approved, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, but rightly dividing the word of truth.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I'll tell you, there've been times somebody said, well, all you got to do is open your mouth and God will feel it. Yeah, I've opened mine a lot of times and nothing come out.
Yeah.
I'm sure, brother, I'll see Brother Aiden over laughing. We've all done it, you know.
Praise
and
God.
You wonder why, because you hadn't been doing your studying.
Yep.
Seeking God.
Uh-huh.
Praying without ceasing. You know why I said pray without ceasing?
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
How can you pray without ceasing? You can have a prayer in your heart, no matter.
Yep.
no matter what's going on.
Come on.
Amen.
I remember a woman some years ago, we were in an old-fashioned revival. This has been 25 years ago, or maybe longer, probably longer. And a woman called and wanted to talk to the pastor in the office, and I went in the office and I picked up the receiver and she said, "I'm going to kill myself." I said, "Who are you?" "Never mind, I'm going to kill myself." I began to pray in my heart and talk to her at the same time.
Amen.
I said, "Lady," I said, "look, we're in revival here at the church. And I said, if you'll come, we'll pray for you." "Oh no," she said, "I'm afraid to be around people." I kept praying in my heart, and finally I said, "If you will come," I said, "where are you at?" She said, "I'm over on the east side of Detroit." She lied. Because when I told her, I said, "If you'll come, I'll meet you outside and walk in with you." She said, "Okay," said, "I'm just around the corner from your church."
Yeah.
Now, I'll be honest, I thought I was going to see a drunk woman when she came. She got out of her car and parked it and walked just as straight as a judge towards me. Depressed, I could tell that. She walked in with me. I done told the congregation that this woman was coming. I got her up front and we started praying for her. She was demon possessed. She started fighting. And all of a sudden down on the floor she went. And we still was praying for her. And she began to speak in tongues. Now I don't know. The devil can talk in tongues also.
Amen.
You know that? Anybody know that?
Yes.
Oh yeah. He imitates God in everything he's trying to do.
Yes, he does.
But she came up and she did have a beautiful testimony. She said, "I'm a member of Satan's club here in Detroit." She said, "I'm a member of it." And she had warned the people not to read their horoscope.
Yeah.
"Don't you read your horoscope." Well, that was good advice she gave.
Yes.
But the next night, the revival ceased at my church, and it started over on Burner Highway. Some of you know where Burner Highway is at. And she went over there and tried to kill the evangelist. So the devil either went back in her. How many know they can go back in her?
Yeah.
If you let them, they can come back in you.
Yeah.
So the devil's real.
Yes.
Now he don't have that. Jesus dethroned him. He has a deception power.
Yeah.
And if he can deceive you and talk you into things that's not real, he'll do it. But he doesn't have power. Thank God he doesn't have power over the child of God.
Amen.
We're more than conquerors.
Yes.
Yes. To him who loved us. Greater is he that's in us than the devil that's in the world.
Amen.
That's right.
So
amen.
I'm just believing God tonight. As I asked everybody out in the internet world to pray with me, many of you are lost and you hear this message. Many of you need some joy that are weak and discouraged. Many of you feel like pulling up the white flag and surrendering. Many of you tonight are going through trials and tests and you don't know what's happening to you. The Bible says, "Count it not strange if some strange thing happened to you. But the trying of your faith is going to work patience. And there's a reward for those that endure temptation." I want you to bow your head in the internet world and pray with me as the people here in the congregation bows their head. And if you really mean it from your heart, if you're in a convalescent home, a nursing home, if you're in a prison, jailhouse, death row, I don't care where you're at. If you will humble yourself and ask God for his mercy, David said, "The mercy of the Lord endureth forever." If you will do that and say, "Lord, I'm a sinner, save me." Will you pray that kind of prayer? If you really sincere mean it, God will, you know, we can send the word. We can't be there to lay hands on you and pray. But we can do the next thing. God sent the word and healed the people. I'm going to send the word. I'm going to send the word of God to you. I want you to bow your head and pray with me. Say, "Dear God in heaven," repeat that after me. "I'm a sinner. I'm lost. I need you, Lord. I've heard the word preached tonight. I'm at home. My husband is on alcohol. My wife taking drugs. My children are on drugs. Lord, I need your help. My life is miserable. I need you now, Jesus, to come in and save me and redeem me and write my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. Lord, I'm calling on you right now. My friends, the Bible says, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. He that cometh to me, I will no wise turn away. That means he'll take you in. And if you sincerely mean this, there is no doubt in my heart that you can be a born-again Christian right now. I believe that the joy of the Lord is going to fill your heart right now. Sometimes it seems like I see people rejoicing and lifting their hands. Some of them jump out of bed and praise God. Some of them might be laughing at me right now, making fun of me. But I've said many times, God has the last laugh.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, you've accepted the Lord. You've made him the Lord of your life. You've got a new God now, and his name is Jesus.
Amen.
The Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. Right now, we believe with all of our heart that you're saved and born again. If you really sincere mean it, we want you to write us. If Brother Don comes and gives you some information, I asked you earlier to get your pencil and paper and come and Brother Don right now and give them some information. Or they can contact us. Please let us hear from you. We got a prayer table up here that we lay hands on, and every prayer request that we get, we pray for them. And we don't tear them up. I heard one fellow was taking prayer requests were sent to him. He had a dumpster. He'd open it up and get the money out and put the prayer request, not even read it, into a dumpster, and they caught him doing that. There's a lot of religious cons, friend. But I want you to know the Trenton Church of God is real tonight. We love you. And it's my goal to see you saved and born again and redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. As Brother Don comes to give you some information how you can reach us, please write us and let us know. I've got a lot of people I know that's listening to me, a lot of my kin folks down in West Virginia. And one of my nieces said, oh, I enjoyed every service. So go ahead, Brother Don.
We're gonna pray for our prayer table right now. So if you send in your prayer requests, we'll put them here.
Father, we thank
your Heavenly Father.
We join in prayer and supplication before the Lord.
You know what's going on.
God, these requests are important, as you know.
I ask you,
and we pray, God, that you grant these petitions. Love these people, Lord, and come into their hearts and redeem them. Heal them, Lord. Cast out devils right now in the name of Jesus and command them to leave. Get out of that temple, Lord. It's God's house now. In Jesus' name, we take authority over it. Praise God. They got to flee. They got to go. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Praise God.
Now, there's three ways.
Praise God.
First, you can write us a letter here at Trenton Church of God.
Hallelujah to the Lamb.
Our address is 35 Rory, Trenton, Michigan. Our zip code is 48183. Again, that's 35 Rory, Trenton, Michigan, 48183. The second way is to send us an email at cookies12@wyan.org. That's cookies12@wyan.org. The third way, the most important one, is you can visit us on the web. There you can look at our church. There you can see upcoming events. There you can pay your tithes. It's a secure type of way to pay your tithes or give the church just a general offering.
Yes.
And that, and like I said, it's secure. We have some people that are starting to pay their tithes and that. And that's TrentonChurchOfGod.com. There you can also see sermons. You can click on, when you click on sermons, you'll see a whole list, a whole year, over a year's worth of sermons. You can click on any one of those months, those dates, and that sermon, go through them. Pick out your favorite. You can also order some of those sermons. And there, also, we have, in this church, we have a powerful prayer cloth ministry. We send out prayer cloths all the time. We give out prayer cloths all the time. We probably send out over 400 prayer cloths. All we have to do is just hear from you. We'll anoint it. We'll pray over it. It's three crosses on a hill. It comes from Acts 19, verses 11 and 12, and it said, God wrought special miracles by the hand of Paul, so that from his body were brought unto the sick handkerchiefs or aprons, and the diseases departed from them, and the evil spirits went out of them. We'll anoint it, we'll pray over it, and we'll send it to you. On our website, TrentonChurchGod.com, there is a form there that you can fill out. Fill out all the areas on there. In your comments, you can put your prayer request. In the comments, if you have a comment that you want to make about our broadcast and stuff, make sure you put your name and your email address, and just fill out the comments section and hit submit. Here, if you'd like to come, be a part of us. We have three services, two on Sunday, one on Wednesday. Sunday morning starts at 10:30 a.m. On Sunday evening at 6, and on Wednesdays at 7 o'clock. So come, be a part of us, be a blessing, and get a blessing. Thank you.
I want to say one thing about people sending their tithes. Your tithes belong in your local church. Don't send them here. But if you don't have a church and you want to get a receipt at the end of the year for your income tax, we'll give you a receipt. If you don't have nowhere to send your tithes, you can send them here. But if you do have a church, please give it to that pastor. He needs them. All right. Now, we'll see you next Sunday. God bless you.